Good morning, students. In today's session, we are going to discuss about what you mean by overloading in C++. Before we're going to start this overloading, I'll give an example. Right? For example, in C, here hash include iostream.h, right? Hash include stdio.h. Now, in this program, I'm going to use one function add. In this program, I'm going to use one function add. This add function is going to perform addition of two integers. Right? Again, in the same program, I'm going to try to perform addition of two floating point numbers. Right? Here, in C, is it possible to use these two at a time? Here, addition of two integers, right? Addition of two floating point numbers in the same scope. Is it possible to perform these two at a time? Scope is same here. In a single program, I'm going to try to execute addition of two numbers, integers. I'm going to try to execute addition of two floating point numbers in a C program. Right? Here, while I'm going to try to execute this one, here I'm going to get one error. Right? Here, function is, here we are using the, we are reusing the function. And compiler doesn't understand which function is going to be invoked first. See, compiler doesn't know whether it should execute add integer comma integer function or else it is going to execute add float comma float function. Compiler doesn't understand which function is has to be executed. Here, in this case, to avoid such type of things, we are going to use function overloading. Here, in C++, we can use these functions. We can use same functions with the same name and just we are having different types of parameters. See here, in this case, here integer parameter list is there. Here we are going to pass float parameter list, parameters are there. So we can use this type of functions in C++. Compiler knows, depending upon the parameter list, it is the C++ compiler is going to invoke that particular method. This type of operation is known as overloading. Yeah, one more thing. Why C++ is supported overloading concept? Why? Because C++ is a structured programming language. As well as object-oriented programming language. That's the reason C++ supports overloading concept. C++ allows to specify more than one definition for a function name or operator in the same scope. See here, in this previous example here, say, addition of two numbers, add int comma int. Here I am performing the integer, addition of two numbers, right? Here I am performing addition of two floating point numbers. See here, function name is same, but the definition is different. Why? Because here, in this function definition is performing addition of two integers. Here, it is going to perform addition of two floating point numbers. So function definition is different. But here we are going to use. Remember one thing: we are going to use the same functions in the same scope, right? C++ allows to specify more than one function definition for a function name or an operator in the same scope. In the same scope, we are going to use this one. In the same scope, see here, in the same scope, we are going to use this same function name but with different functions definition, which is known as the function overloading or operator. In the same way, we can perform the operators also. We can overload the operators also in C++, but we can't overload the operators in C program. We can't overload the operators, right? Here C++ allows overloading concepts. Why? Because C++ is a structured programming language and object oriented programming language. That's the reason C++ is supporting overloading concepts. Here C++ supports two types of overloading. First one is the function overloading, second one is the operator overloading. In function overloading, we are going to use the same function name but the definition is different in the same scope, whereas in operator overloading, we are going to perform various we are going to define the operator definition. We are going to define the operator definition in the same scope, right? First we will go for the function overloading. Here in overloaded declaration is that which is declared within the same name as previously declared declaration in the same scope, right? Here in function overloading, we are going to pass different types of parameters. In function overloading, we are going to pass the different types of parameter list. Parameter list must be different. When an overloaded function or operator is called, the compiler is going to determine the most appropriate different definition to use. See here, in this example, if I am going to use the same function, if I am going to use the same thing in C++ concept, see here. Include IOStream, right? Here I'm going to use one display function. This display function doesn't have any parameters. Next, again, why display int I? Why display int I? Right? Same again, void display float I. Right? Why display float? See here, in the given example, whenever here I am going to try to institute this program. Here display function is there. First display function doesn't have any parameter list. Second display function is having only one parameter, that is the integer. So then third display function is there, that is the floating point number is there. Now here whenever we are going to try to execute this program, here first I am going to create one object. Here I am going to create one object here by using this object dot here display 5. Object dot display 5. Whenever the compiler is going to read this statement, directly control is going to transfer here. First it will check. Why display? Here display is there, function name is there, here display is there, display is there, display is there. Three display functions are there. Now compiler is going to check which function is to be invoked. First parameter list is 5. First it will check. Here in this display function there is no parameters are there. So compiler is not going to invoke this one. Next, why display int I? See here, we are passing the integer value. Directly compiler is going to invoke this display function. Directly compiler is going to invoke why display int I 5 function is going to be invoked. This method is going to be invoked. Depending upon the parameter list, that particular function is going to be invoked. This is the specialty of C++ compiler. Now, for example, here in this case, obj dot display 7.978. obj dot display 7.978. In this case, whenever here display compiler is going to read these three functions, then it is going to check for the 7.978. Here value is there. First it will check with this display function. Here no value is there, so it is not going to invoke this function. Next, Y display int I. Here we are passing the floating point number. It is not going to invoke this one. Next, Y display float 7.978. Yes, it is going to invoke the third function which is passing the floating point number. So, C++ compiler is going to check with the first, it will check with the function name whether the particular function is present in the particular scope or not. Then it is going to check for the parameters which we are going to pass in the function call. Here, depending upon the parameter, that particular function is going to be invoked. Right? See. When an overloaded function or operator call, the compiler determines the most appropriate definition to use by comparing the argument types. Right? First, it will check with the integer, float, character, void, whatever it may be. What type of arguments we are passing in the function call, depending upon that particular function is going to be invoked. Right? In the same way, it is going to perform in the operator overloading also. And function overloading is simple. In function overloading, multiple definitions for this same function name can be used in the same scope. Already we discussed that. Here, in function overloading, function name is same, but the parameter list is different. In some cases, return type is different. In some cases, parameter list is different. But all those functions must be defined in the same scope. All those functions must be defined in the same scope. For example, same scope is within that particular class or within that particular function. Within that particular function or within the particular class, those functions must be defined or declared. The definition of the function must differ from each other by the type or the list number of arguments in the argument list. See here. Here, we are passing this. Here, we are not going to pass any value here. Here, we are passing the integer value. Here, we are passing the floating point value, right? See here, in this case, we are not passing any value here. We are passing here integer value. Here, we are passing the floating point value. So, it means that here, function definition is different or else function argument list is different, right? And one more thing, function declaration that differ only by the return type can't be overloaded. Here in next session, I am going to discuss this third point. Why the function declaration can't be overloaded, which is differ in the only in return type. Right? See, for example, see here. IOStream, here first hash include IOStream.h using namespace std class print data. Here I am using class print data. Print data is that my class name is print data. In my class, I am going to use print method is there. White print, here also white print, here also white print is there. Right? In this case, first I am going to print the integer value. In next case, I am going to print the double value. Here I am going to perform addition of two numbers. Here I am going to perform addition of two numbers. Int A equals to 5, B equals to 6, C equals to A plus B. Next I am going to printing the value of C. See here function name is same. Print. Function name is same. See here. Return type is same. Void. Return type is same. And here argument list is different. Here I am passing the integer value. Here I am passing the double value. Here I am not going to pass any value. See here. In function overloading, here the function definition, the function must differ from each other by the type or the number of arguments. See here, number of arguments. Argument is different here. Int I is here, argument is integer, here argument is display, here we don't have any argument. See, arguments are different, so this is satisfying the property of function overloading. Next, and one more thing, must differ from each other by the types and the R and R the number of arguments in the argument list. Here, function definition must be different. Here, function definition must be different. See here. Function definition is different here. Here in first print method, we are printing the value of the integer, right? Here in the definition of print, this method, we are printing the integer value. Here in this definition of this void print double d method, we are printing the double value. Here in void print method, here we are performing the addition of two numbers. See here, in first case, we are printing the integer value. In second case, we are printing the double value. In third case, we are performing the addition of two numbers. It means that here function definition is different. Function definition is different. And one more thing, see here, white painting I, white paint double D, white paint, all these three are present in the same scope. Same scope means in the same class definition. In the same class definition, all these three functions are, three methods are present. Right? Up to here, clear? Function name is same. We are passing the different types of arguments and the function definition is different. So it is satisfying the property of function overloading. Now I am going to here. Now how we are going to call these functions, right? First, check this out. Int main void, here print data pd. See here, print data. Here I am creating the object. To call these methods which are present in print data class, we have to create the object. By using the object, we can call the methods which are present in the class, right? Already we discussed regarding this one. By using the object, we can call the methods or we can call the functions which are present in the class, right? Here I am creating one method, here I am creating one object, that is pd. pd.printfile. Whenever the compiler is going to read pd.printfile, see here, pd.print, right? Directly control is going to transfer here. Void print is there. So compiler is going to checking that which method is going to be invoked. Here in class, how many methods are there? Three methods are there. Now which method is going to be invoked first? Right? Print is there. Three methods are with the same name. Now compiler is going to decide which method is going to be invoked. How the compiler is going to decide? See here, file is there. Right? Depending upon the argument, we are going to, the compiler is going to invoke the method. Phi is an integer. First it will check. See here, phi, integer. So, compiler is going to invoke this method. Cout print integer, value of I is printing integer, that is phi. Right? Now, first it will invoke the method which is having void print int I. Next, pd.print500.263. Whenever the compiler is going to read this statement, directly control is going to transfer to the class. First, it will check void print int I. Here, we are passing the double value. So, here we are passing the integer value. Compiler is not going to invoke this method. Directly control is going to transfer to the next method, void print double D. So, here we are passing the double data, 500.263. We are passing the double data, directly control is going to transfer here, it will print the value double 500.263, right? Next, in third case, compiler is going to read this statement pd.print. Here we are not passing any parameters, directly here. Whenever the compiler is going to read this statement, directly control is going to transfer to the class. First, it will check with the void print int I. Here we are not passing any value, so compiler is not going to execute this statement. Next, it will check for the next statement, void print double D. Here also no, double data is there. In function call, there is no parameter list is there. So it is not going to invoke this method, directly void print here. Print method is there, this doesn't have any parameter. So call function and calling function both are matching. Then it is going to invoke the function definition which is present in the void print method. So int a equals to 5, b equals to 6, c equals to a plus b, 5 plus 6 equals to 11. So c out printing the value of c equals to 11, right? Then it is return 0, closing the braces. So now whenever the compiler is going to read return 0 statement, it is going to return thunder, it is going to exit thunder particular function call. Now what is my output here? Printing integer value I 5, printing floating value, here I am passing 500.263, so it is going to print the value, printing the value of c is 11, right? Now we are going to implement in this in their C++ software, right? Thank you.